Thank you. Test, test, okay. All right, thank you. Today I'm going to be talking a little bit about Ingrid Stolzel. And my interest in Ingrid Stolzel and presenting her to you this afternoon is because she actually came to UW-La Crosse in 2020. And so got to know her a little bit and played some pieces that she had when she came. She came for what's known as Arts Fest today. And after that, I ended up looking into more of her music, and so I'm going to be playing a piece of hers this afternoon. Some quick biography highlights. She is German. She moved to the U.S. in 1991, and she has her DMA in composition from the University of Missouri Kansas City Conservatory. And she got her master's in composition from the Hart School of Music, which is in Hartford, Connecticut. And she currently teaches at the University of Kansas School of Music. So she's there. And so she has really enjoyed that aspect of both teaching and composing. In particular, she felt like at UMKC, that when she started, or when she got into composition, so many composers who identify as women reached out to her, were very supportive of her, and she enjoys that she gets to do that same thing. Just a couple of things about her music is she's a melodist at heart. She strives to use melody to connect emotionally with the listener. She has composed for all types of instrumentation, yeah, so you can kind of see there. So I'm playing solo piano today, but I've played her chamber music in the past. And one of the things that's also interesting to note about her compositions, especially in her chamber music, is that she will often have a chamber piece and then she'll say, well, you can score it for this or this. And so it's interesting to see how things identify. So for example, she wrote a composed a piece called There Are Things to Be Said, and originally it was for piano and flute and clarinet. When we played this piece here at UWL, Dr. Erickson played soprano saxophone. So you can see that there are some gestures into that. She often looks to poetry to help use it to compose. She often writes very introspective works, and this is an introspective work. And I wanted to play a little bit of this because I think you will see her perspective and her idea in both the piece that I'm playing and in this chamber piece. And it's the idea that she uses space, both in time and also in range, in the idea of pitches. So I'm going to play a little bit of the beginning of this piece. And by the way, this is the Germain Taffer trio, who is another composer, and then this trio took that name. So here we go. This is There Are Things to Be Said. see if I can get it to go to 8 minutes. I probably went a little further than I wanted to, but I think you can see that there are things to be said, and yet the way that she thinks about composing that is to actually let silence and kind of these large ideas sort of rest in there. Obviously, she's using an amount of dissonance with that too. So a little bit about the piece that I'm about to play for you. So I looked at her solo piano music, and this piece was called In the Midst. And it was composed in 2013, and that is when Van Cliburn passed away. So I thought I'd share a little bit about Van Cliburn. By show of hands, how many of you have heard of Van Cliburn? Maybe you went. Dr. Borja has. Good for Dr. Borja. Did you meet him once? Van Cliburn is pretty special to the United States because he went to the Tchaikovsky International Competition, which is one of the major piano competitions in Russia, and Khrushchev was in charge in Russia, and Van Cliburn went there, and then he played the Tchaikovsky piano concerto, and the judges went to Khrushchev and they said, we'd like to award the top medal to Van Cliburn from the United States. And Khrushchev said, is he the best? And they said, yes, and they said, okay. So Van Cliburn won that medal in 1958. This ended up being very, very important because in 57, Sputnik happened, right? Russians reached space, and he now does this. He is the only classical musician who has ever received a ticker tape parade here in the United States. So when he came back from that. So, and of course, the piece that he played was the Tchaikovsky piano concerto, and so I want you to hear a little bit of this beginning, because this is what inspired Ingrid Stoltzel to compose the piece that she did. It's these opening piano chords. Okay, so those are kind of the chords that she took. So to write a piece inspired by the passing of Van Cliburn, she chose to use those chords as kind of the opening. You're going to hear a lot of space and time used into that. And by the way, one of the things that happened is in 1962, the first Van Cliburn International Piano Competition, which is still going today, happened. And Ingrid wrote this for Stanislav Yudenich, and he was one of the winners of the Van Cliburn, all right? And so, and then he was part of the Van Cliburn Memorial Recital that happens. I think it's in 2014. So, In the Midst by Ingrid Stoltzel. Thank you.
Thank you.